Welcome back to Wasteland 2. I need to convince the HCC members to vote for Veronica. And in the last episode, I wasn't sure where the HCC actually was. So I just looked it up on a wiki or something like that. I just googled it, and it turns out the HCC is not actually like a... It's not a building. There isn't a building where you just find the HCC members or something like that. The people in the HCC are actually just kind of like major shop owners around this whole place. So I just wrote down the names of all the people in the HCC, and I'm going to go visit them. First one on the list is Rambo. Or Rambu. So, like, you want to vote for Veronica? I'll give you 20,000 million bucks. You want Rambo to vote against Madam Heidi? No. Well, not do it. Heidi is a good woman. A strong leader. She saves Hollywood. Why would he do zzzings? I don't even know how to pronounce that stuff. I'm not gonna do the accent. No way. I refuse. Well, you see, Veronica will actually make peace between Hollywood and the Bastion. It's true. With peace, Rambo could sell guns to the priests without shooting himself in the foot, yes? could be nothing but talk. If you wish Rambo to support Madame Veronica, he must see what she can do, no? Ooh, I have it. Someone's been stealing Rambo's guns. Very tricky. No break-in. No damage. The guns, they just vanish. If you find the thief in Rambo's guns, I will vote for Madame Veronica. Fair enough. I have no idea where the thief would actually be, though. I totally did not just pay attention to what that guy said. But I feel like I'm supposed to follow him. Something's happening. Ooh. Whoa. And Jason's about to die. Goodbye. Jason's about to be deleted. You picked the most isolated alley in Hollywood. This is not an alley. You're just in the road. In no way can this be construed as an alley. Ooh, level up. Level Lupe.
Congratulations.
10 points. Demolition's pointless. Shotgun. Let's go with energy weapons. Alright, shall we follow? We listened in, blah blah blah. We should tell Rambo what happened, that his problem is solved. I guess we don't pursue. I don't know if we actually solved the problem, though. Didn't he want the guns back? I guess I caught the thief, but I certainly didn't get his weapons back. Yo, Jason! He's been stealing your shit! And we got his vote. Sweet. Oh, you know what? I should actually go sell my weapons. Although, maybe I should just break them down. Yeah, let's do that. I could actually use the occasional BART. especially underbarrel things. Don't care to strip these though, those don't matter. Just gonna sell them. Long barrel, interesting. It's pretty low tier for weaponsmithing. Still pretty damn good though. It's a barrel modification. How many weapons have barrel mods? Ooh, that could use one. A long barrel on a submachine gun. That's kind of strange, but let's do it. Sell my junk. Guess I'll keep the suppressor. High-powered scope. Yeah, I'll keep one. Just selling major things. Don't care about getting every last little thing. Should I clear out most of the weight? And how are we doing on armor, by the way? Because there's this new kind of armor. Yeah, this stuff, the Spectrum Assault Vest. And I have, what, four of them? Yeah, I've got four of them. So three people still need newer armor. I think it's pretty damn expensive, though, but let's see. 1,500? Nah, I've got plenty of money. Let's do it. Sell the old vests back. And I think we are good. Okay, so that's Rambo crossed off my list. There we go. Next is, well, I guess whoever's closest, which would be Manny. He's another member of the HCC. And I believe I... Wait, did I blackmail him? No, I was going to, but I ended up handing him the photos. So maybe he'll be very happy? I hope. Yo, you wanna vote for Veronica? Sweet. That was easy. I like it when people cooperate. Cross him off my list. Now I believe the person in here, I think, is also a member of the HCC. Nice to see you clean up all the blood in here. Yo! Wanna vote for Veronica? Sweet! That's three off my list. I guess this would be harder if I was doing this earlier, when I hadn't actually helped all these people, but I've already helped them, so they're like, sure, I'll do whatever.
Congratulations, Echo.
5 points. Not enough for anything. Okay, this last one is probably going to be hard. In fact, it's probably going to be impossible. So the last one is actually Duke Schwag. This is not the right place. Yeah, so Schwag is that douchebag that doesn't want to talk to me. The one that I almost blew up, actually. Since I kind of want to wipe him out. Since he's involved in the slave trade. So, yeah, I don't think this is gonna work. We'll see. For some reason, I can ask Flo to vote, but according to the wiki I looked at, it's Duke Schwag that's actually the one that is actually a member of the HCC. I think she's just speaking on his behalf or something. Alright, let's see. You want Duke to vote against Heidi? Good luck. Duke knows that as long as he plays his HCC dues, Heidi won't poke her nose in his business. Why would he change that? Unless you give him a good reason. Find some hard evidence against him, prove he's slaving, then he might have to work with you. I think I already have the evidence, don't I? I mean, don't I have that piece of paper or something, like the list of everybody's names and shipment stuff? Where is that? Oh yeah, I wanted to try on some clothes too. The black corset. It's kind of cool looking. And then, what else? There's something else. I think it was this. That looks pretty cool. I'm gonna go with these though. Anyway, the evidence. I don't know where it is, maybe I gave it away. Oh, here we go. It says circumstantial evidence that Duke Schwag works with the slavers. So I guess it's not super strong evidence. Let me see if I can speak with him. Yo, open up. He really is not going to open up. Okay, well, I have no idea where to find stronger evidence. One thing I can do, which I'm going to do right now, is go back to Veronica. Because Veronica said that if I have trouble getting votes, securing votes from anybody, that I should go back to her and see if she can do something about it. So let's go do that. Have I collected enough? I think actually three might be enough. I'm just gonna say no, but let's see. Alright, so she can't do anything about it actually. She cannot help me. Let's see. We have enough votes to vote in Veronica and kick out Heidi. Time to tell Veronica to call the meeting. I guess I don't need any more. I thought she wanted four though. Alright, well, let's do it. Amazing. I would not have believed it was possible. But I'm afraid you still have another impossible task ahead of you before we can make our move. Ascension must be in power at the Bastion. If... when you help him gain control. Return to me, and we'll go to the council meeting to confront Heidi. Oh. Okay. Well, I guess I know where I'm going. Let's go follow the robot. So how am I gonna help him? Wait a minute. Wait, is this the way I should go? Or should I go the other way? How did I get in to, like, how did I get to talk to the broken man? Or Ascension, or whatever his name is, how did I get to talk to him? Wasn't that through the sewers? I can't remember. There's a certain pathway that I took. Actually, I think it might have been this. Ah, yeah, this is the way. Okay, cool. Is it you again? Have you come to a decision? Do you wish to join the Church Vigilant and become a torturer? No. I see no reason to continue talking, but we will keep each other's secrets, won't we? Wait, so how do I help him? Do I have to join his church to help him, or what? How does this work? I have no freaking idea. I guess I'll just continue and see what happens? I don't know. Hey, what's up? Hello, woman. Sure, I'll take some healing. Whoa. Before you is a tall, broad-shouldered white guy with jet black hair and a strong jaw, and more trophy eyeballs than anyone else. His cruel smile, however, belies his heroic looks. A paladin has asked you to stop, aspirants. A direct order. Will you obey? Sure. I figured, you hear like an obedient dog. An excellent beginning. Now then, the Salvation Church forbids alcohol and drugs in the Bastion. If you carry any on your person, you must hand them over immediately so that we can dispose of them properly. Open your pack immediately and provide at least one illicit item to provide your to prove your good faith. Alcohol and drugs. I don't actually know if I have any. Oh, I guess the... Well, I mean, pain relievers are drugs, but they're not... You know, they're not like illegal drugs. Oh, here we go. Booze. Well done, aspirant. I would ask you to lick my boots now, but that would be redundant. You may go. Down the hatch? He's drinking the booze I just gave him? Fucking hypocrite. Anything fancy? Nope. I could use some more ammunition, though. Yeah, this is the stuff that I'm pretty low on, right? The 7.62? Let me just make sure of that. 7.62, 7.62... Yeah, 7.62. Wouldn't mind buying some more. .40 should do, I think. Go ahead and spread that out a little bit. Where in the heck am I? Alright, well, before I go crazy exploring this pretty massive place, let's continue to explore inside. Does this entire place exist solely for this one little chest? It's a stash of booze. And the story of Samson, part one. Where did it go? Ah, there it is. I don't think I want to know more about Samson. Some crazy, bloodthirsty dude. Any story of man is a story of sin, and thus the story begins with mankind burning for his sins. Basically, every single faction here is a group of crazies. I don't want anything to do with them, and that's about it. I know, it's a very nuanced view. Retribution Jones. I've heard that name before. I'm not sure if I should interrupt. I probably shouldn't, but I'm curious what would happen. Hey, what's going on? Retribution is a tall, thin man with a high forehead and a cold glint in his eyes. He wears body armor under his militia uniform. Samson's hammer, you're pathetic. What are you supposed to be, cowboys? This is an army, not a costume party. And I suppose you're here to join up with the church militant? Damnation. The things God sends to test me, I swear. Now, speak up. Why are you pencil necks cluttering up my office? Can I just, like, not join any of the factions? Because I really don't want to. Tell me about church militant. Bravest, most well-trained, best equipped. Yeah. We like to kill people, blah, blah, blah. I don't really particularly care about any of these people, to be honest. And I don't want to join, so I'm just going to go. What in the hell is this? Oh my god. Hello? I've heard your name before. Before you is a stunningly beautiful woman in a white woman's business suit, with a jacket and a skirt. Though she tries to project cheer and love for the church, she has a haunted look. And a black eye. Welcome to the chapel, aspirants, and my congratulations on making it through the gauntlet of Samson. Wait, when did I make it through the gauntlet of Samson? I mean, of course. Thank you. It was very difficult. I am Sister Preacher Faelty Mayweather, wife of Evangelist Malediction Mayweather. I'm sorry my husband could not personally tell you of the church ecstatic, but he is unfortunately too busy with his holy duties. May I help you? Church militant. Church ecstatic. So they are the interpreters. They're the ones who interpret the teachings of James King and Red Samson and turn them into law. Okay. Ask about Heidi. Apparently she does not like Heidi at all. A whore and a defiler of innocence. A seducing witch who lures good, upstanding men to adultery and debauchery. Oh my. You seem to know a lot about her. Do you know her? Certainly not. I've heard stories, that's all. It has nothing to do with me. What do you know about the Paladins? The Paladins are my husband's bodyguards and his most, intimate confidants. It's the bravest, most loyal men in the church, if sometimes prone to arrogance. It sounds like the Paladin's closeness with your husband disturbs you. No, I have no problem with the Paladins. It just seems sometimes that they seem more of a husband than I do. See more of my husband than I do. But that is the nature of their job, isn't it? Indeed. So what's up with the black eye? It's nothing. I fell against a candlestick. Oh my god. I'm not sure whether to find that funny or just really disturbing. There's an imprint of a ring on your eyelid. I appreciate your concern, but it was just an accident, nothing more. Is it the husband? Somebody with a ring apparently did it. Although with all these churches, I bet pretty much everybody has freaking rings. Most of the books on the shelf are copies of the James King Bible, though you notice a few books about weapon maintenance and astronomy. It's too bad I can't read them. Alright, I think that's it for inside. Let's go out. Let me just take a look at my quests. Yeah, so it just says, Veronica has asked us to put Ascension McDade in Power of the Bastion. I have no idea how to go about doing that. Hello! I am Sister Preacher Constance Yee, the Bastion's official greeter and guide, and I would be happy to help you get your bearings here among God's chosen. Would you like some directions, or would you rather explore on your own? I'm just gonna explore. Plaque on the pedestal reads, A lie, the dead eye, Aluk, what, the first rock? How the hell do you pronounce that? Aluakayan? Might be right. Alwakayan. Oh my. Can I hack it? Nope. Who are you calling scum, scum? Wait a minute. Luis Bermudez, aren't you the person we were supposed to save? Isn't the guy that died that was in my group like Alex Bermudez or something? Well, I guess this guy's gonna shoot me if I move inside, so let's not push it. The enormous doors of the Bastion look impenetrable. What's up? A young woman in a penitent's outfit stands in front of a shack with a sign on it that reads, Samson's Snack Shop. She keeps her eyes firmly on the ground. You're the Desert Rangers, ain't you? The priests have been listening to your broadcasts a lot. They think you're like them, but you're not, are you? You're real good guys. Or are you? Are you here to convert? Are you gonna join the militia? Hell no! I knew it! The Rangers ain't stupid enough to fall for some preacher's lies. Not like me. You're here for something else. I can tell. I mean, no. No, I won't tell. Your secret's safe with me, Rangers, I promise. And any info you need, let me know. You see a lot around here, serving burgers. Just, whatever you're doing, could you help me escape when you leave? I want to go back home so bad. Can't talk here, too many ears, maybe behind the shop later on, it's more private. Okay, if by later on you mean 2 seconds later, sure. So, where are you from? I'm from Pacoima. Back then, I thought it was the most godforsaken place on Earth. I didn't know godforsaken until I joined the militia. Tell me about Pacoima. It's in the San Fernando Valley. Practically a paradise. Lots of ruined car lots to scavenge from. Big houses to squat in. Lots of old diners with canned goods we can harvest. God, I don't know why I left. It's so stupid. I'd give anything for just a little reminder of home. And why do you want to escape? I came here a few months back. I heard a preacher speak when the militia crusade came through my town. I thought the Gospel of Samson was exactly what the world needed, and I decided I'd come to Hollywood to join up. It's okay, you can tell us. We're here to help. What happened when you joined up? It wasn't like I expected. The church don't care about good or bad, they just kill whoever's got something they want. And they ain't godly men. Half of them are adulterers, and worse. I fought back when they tried to with me, and they called me a sinner. Made me wear these rags, sweep the floors, serve burgers. I wanted to run, but nobody runs. The monsters in the hills, they eat anybody who tries to escape. I want so bad to tell you to take me away from here right this minute, but I can't run off and leave the others. Tell you what, Rangers. Find a way to get all the penitents out of here, and I'll come too. But until then, I'm gonna stay. I'd never be able to live with myself. What do you say? Sure. Thank you. You free the others, and I'll be right there with them. So tell me about this crusade. The pistol-packing priests make sweeps of local villages to find penitents, which is just their friendly name for slaves. Any info? Just look through this real quick. Mayweather? Let's see. So, power-hungry asshole. You want to bring him down, you might could talk to his wife, poor Fealty, another black eye every week. Okay, so yeah, he's a complete douchebag. And tell me about his wife. Real sweetheart? Okay. She'd been another man's wife, a paladin by the name of Sims, but he got shot on patrol. Tell me about Sims. I wasn't here yet when this happened, but I heard Sims got promoted from the church militant to the paladins, and then got himself shot by raiders on his first patrol. Lots of people thought that was suspicious at the time, especially after how fast Mayweather moved in on Fealty. But, well, he's the evangelist. Who's gonna say anything? Oh god, he probably murdered her husband. If you want to ask somebody about it, ask Paladin Captain White. Not that the creep will give you a straight answer, but he's the one who carried Sims home after he died. And you know this White? I knew men like him back home. Fellows with a little bit of power who want to rub it in everybody's face. His head'll stay fresh on a pike for weeks with the amount of alcohol he guzzles. Good to know. Where can we find alcohol? Well, I've already found some in the stash. Some of the vigilant boys keep a stash somewhere inside the bastion. Paladins? They're the Mayweather's elite bodyguards. Though as far as I can tell, they're more of his drinking buddies. Ah yes, Ascension McDade. Apparently the reason I'm actually here, although I don't know if I care about him that much. Three churches, okay. So I wonder if I can free all of the penitents while also putting Ascension McDade in power. I don't know. It sounds kind of tricky. What's going on? Oh, there's Sanctity White. The one who transported Sims over when he died. The one who carried him. Excuse me. Nobody gets through this gate without the express permission of Evangelist Mayweather himself. Okay. Can I go speak to White? Whoa. Okay, sorry. Wait, this is the Paladin Barracks? It's just outside? And it's covered by a fence? It's a shitty barracks. Okay, well, this looks big, but it looks like I can't really go anywhere. Unless I can go out the front door? I don't think so. Whoa. Okay. Never mind. Neat. I'm guessing the fact that I took the back door means I didn't have to go through these people. Do you think they're gonna be suspicious if I talk to them? Hello! Take another Bible and pass it to any sinners you meet in your travels. Sure. So what in the heck is out here? Could go for some shooting. Oh, they were just raising their guns. Seven damage. He is occasionally impressive with how much damage he can do. Jesus Christ, there's badgers, massive frogs, and blood beasts. Let's see, it's bleeding, isn't it? And it's got 3 hit points, so I think it's about to die, so there's no real reason to shoot it. None of them have enough armor to actually justify using an energy weapon, so let's just use this. You know, can you increase the combat animation speed? I don't think I've ever actually looked. I guess it'd be in gameplay. Oh yeah, combat speed. Let's go to 2x. Did that actually save? Yeah, okay. I didn't realize there were so many enemies. I maybe should have positioned my people better. At least Yulia's gonna get some use out of her shotgun, that's for sure.
Oh,
And I died from bleeding. Animations are gonna look a little bit wonky with the combat speed, but it's better than waiting forever for them to move. Come on. Nope. Oh, I didn't mean to click. I think I could have gotten the badger in the cone of fire. Oh well. Punch in the ass. Yeah. Saving the environment, one murder at a time.
Copy, Ranger Team Echo.
Seven points. Let's go for more brawling. I don't get why that's red. Why would increasing your brawling make your base chance to hit go down? Oh, I think it's calculating that percentage based off of your current operating brawling skill, which is actually above what I have my skill points at, because his arms, each one increases the brawling by 2. Wait. But they can't be right. No, they don't both increase it by 2, they together increase it by 2. Yeah, because the skill points are actually at 5, but in reality I have 7. So I think when it has this as red, I think it's because it's calculating it based on 7, is where it's starting from. Which is all sorts of wonky. The freaking treasure hunt out here. Oh. I have to admit, the more I play this game, the more my patience for it goes down. In the old days, I'd disarm every single mine and extract every little tiny bit of XP that I could, but now I just don't care. That's not to say I don't care about the game at all, but you know, it's one of the problems that big kind of open world games like this have. And it's a problem I've had with every massive RPG that I've ever played, whether it be Oblivion or Skyrim. It's just, when you play a game for 60 hours, it's hard for it to not get a bit old after a while. Let's actually position my people this time. This combat is so much more fun at 2x speed. It's actually massively refreshing. I should have done that a long time ago. No thanks. So was this the gauntlet that I'm walking through? The mines and the animals? I think it is. Hello, Billy. Please don't tell the gods and militia we're here. If they know we failed, they'll just come to finish us off. Oh, they've failed the gauntlet. Sorry to hear that. Hardest level 8, I don't have it. Why were you trying to join them? Just looking for a place to belong. HSP kicked us out of Hollywood because we wouldn't pay. HSP, huh? Sure, yeah, we'll square things with the HSP. I don't even know who to talk to about the HSP. Actually, wait, I think I might. What does HSP stand for, though? Is it Hollywood something police? Thank you. Also, how come there's two travel... Like, there's two travel markers. There's one here and there's one here. I think this one goes to the world map and this one goes back to Hollywood, I'm assuming? Oh, Los Feliz. Okay, gotcha. Let's go back to Los Feliz. Welcome, sinners. Thank you. I'm thinking let's go square things away with the HSP. And then call it a day. Yeah, I think I know where the guy is that's in the HSP. I think. I think it's the person that was messing with Ma Brown and her chili shop. I think it's this guy. He should be right here. Let's see, do I have anything that mentions the HSP? Has the HCC? Oh yeah, here we go. I ran across some folks who want to return to Hollywood. They said you wouldn't let them. What can I do to change your mind? Yeah, I think I know who you're talking about. So they couldn't get past the gate of Griffith, huh? I knew they would fail. Let me think. I'll tell you what. You get me a badger nutsack, rabbit foot, and lipstick that a raider would wear, and you got yourself a deal. Or you could just pay me 10,000 scrap and we'll call it a day. Could you have told me that before I sold all my shit? And just to check, that does say 10,000 scrap, right? Not 1,000? 10,000? I got your items. Do I? I think you're lying. Keep looking, pal. Yeah, I don't have them. And what does he mean by a lipstick that a raider would wear? What do you mean? I have a lipstick. I used to have a badger nutsack. I don't know if I have a rabbit foot. How much money do I have? I have 10,184. If I pay him the 10,000, I'm only going to have 184 left. That's like nothing. But then again, what the hell am I saving up my money for? I don't care. Sure. There you go. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have fun tonight. I'm sure you are. And now I am very, very poor.
Copy, Ranger. Congratulations, sir.
Actually, that's probably not the way to go, is it? No, let's go back to Los Feliz.
My name is Matthias, leader of the Children of the Citadel.
7 points? Nice.
News for your future.
Okay, yeah, at this point I need to start putting my skills into something else, because I've already maxed out everything that matters. Question is, what? At this point, anything I put my skills into are... it's pretty much pointless. I guess toaster repair? I mean, what the hell else could it be? I could put it into barter. Increase the value of items being sold by 3%? Woohoo! That does not make much of a difference. Even if it's maxed, it only increases everything by 10%. But given that I am poor, yeah, I'm gonna go with barter. It's locked. Hey, let us through. I don't care what the hell, we're here to hear the word of God, sure. Yeah, well, we're aspirants. Which is through the gate behind me, yes it is. Tell me about the gauntlet. We're ready to try. Are you ready? Yes, we have, I am. Thank you. I almost just lockpicked it out of frustration. It's like, I'm not gonna put up with any of your shit, I'm just gonna get through. But then he would have opened fire and yeah, that would have been bad. And I'm assuming I actually have to come back here to tell them that I helped them, right? Yo, everything's squared away. That is such good news. Thank you so much, Rangers. Ah, I've got that lovely warm feeling in my heart. And that empty feeling in my pocketbook. Okay, well, I think I'm gonna end this episode here. So in the next episode, I have no idea what's going to happen. I don't want to join one of the branches of the church. I do want to free all of the people that are enslaved by them. But I also kind of need to get McDade or whatever his name is, Ascension McDade. I need to get him into office, into power, if I want to help Veronica, which I do. I do want to push Heidi out, but and I do want to help Veronica, but I don't really want to help Ascension McDade because he's a fucking crazy torturer dude. So I have no idea. In reality, I'm probably going to kind of clumsily attempt to talk to people, and it's going to go terribly wrong, and then I'm just going to end up shooting everybody. We'll see. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.